My name is Stefan Schmidt, and I am professor of political science, public administration, and coastal policy. I'm here at the international headquarters of coastal policy, the world headquarters, so to speak. We do a lot of stuff from here. You can see some material on the back there that's related to our various activities. Let me talk to you a little bit about week and module number one of the coastal policy course. First of all, I'd like you to look at some of the other streaming videos that we have on the fact that this is an actual real course, even though it's virtual and taught on the internet, that I would like you to come to this class as frequently as you would to a regular class. In other words, come to the WebCT site, look at your syllabus, print off the syllabus, and do your reading assignments both in the textbook, which is Cornelia Dean's book, Against the Tide, and also the other material that is in each of the links on the homepage in WebCT, module by module. We have some very interesting readings. Paul Schmidt wrote up. Paul Schmidt will be teaching this class, by the way, with us. He's finishing his PhD at the University of Massachusetts in Coastal Zone Management, and you'll meet him later in the course. He wrote up a very nice discussion of what is coastal. Some of it you may already know, some of you don't have that much background, and you may find all of it necessary and interesting, but there are some fascinating things in that little piece he wrote. You can download it. It's a Word document file in the first week folder. And also, I wrote some little brief comments on what is policy and what is politics. All three of those things, coastal, policy, and politics, pertain to this class, and we will be looking at everything in this course through the lens of those three concepts. Remember, when you read Paul's summary on what is coastal, that the world has not looked always the way it does today. Coastal areas were once part of other continents. Some coastal areas were either underwater or in some cases were much higher and drier. So we've had a tremendous amount of change in the world in terms of where coasts are and what they look like. And that's something to remember, because we tend to always, I think that the coastal zones of the world, the islands, the estuaries, the beaches, the marshlands, that are, and the barrier islands that are there today, were always there and will always be there, and that is not the case. In terms of politics, is defined simply as conflict and ways of resolving conflict, and you know very well that the coastal zones of the world and how to manage them, what to do with the land, what to do with zoning, insurance, how to manage the marshlands and wetlands that are the incubators for a lot of marine life. Should they be filled? Should they be drained? How should they be protected? How much construction should there be on the coastal areas? What kind of insurance should we have for people who build there? What kind of development should take place? Those are all very, very conflict-prone kinds of decisions. They're not easy decisions. And so when you start talking about how to manage those coastal areas of the world by having policy initiatives, you get a lot of conflict. Policies, of course, are the sort of end result of politics, and they are the implementation part of politics, where you enact regulations, where you develop strategies and means of conducting business. In that first week and in that first module, I have the syllabus right here in front of me, so I'm just kind of looking at it. You will find that we begin with Cornelia Dean's chapter in her book Against the Tide, which basically reveals a lot about the Galveston, Texas hurricane of 1900. It's wonderful to start out that way, because what happened in 1900 there was sort of an innocence. And after the 1900 hurricane, No one, again, underestimated the power of the seas and oceans and winds. And so coastal zone management and policy has changed dramatically since the 1900 hurricane. And I want you to take a look at that and see what lessons we can learn from that. And then there are some other things in that first module that are very important. For example, there's a discussion about the geology and the formation of the coastal zones and beaches, the west coast versus the east coast in the United States. And you might find it interesting that those two parts of the United States formed very differently, the whole way that erosion took place on the east coast and created these vast and sandy barrier islands and beaches, whereas the west coast has always been subject to the tectonic plates diving under each other, the Pacific plate diving under the North American plate, creating a very abrupt area, not many barrier islands on the west coast of the U.S., and a very different way for beaches to try and renourish themselves, actually primarily through erosion from inland, and since we built dams and all kinds of restrictions on the flow of water from the interior to the beaches of the west coast, some of the renourishment there has been pretty severely impaired and stopped. So I thought, you know, you might want to kind of look at that if you didn't already know that. There's also a great discussion about essentially how beaches are formed, period, how the sand moves up and down beaches, how human barriers, which we will look at even more later, interfere with that. And we also have a little bit of a discussion focused on the more, let's call it philosophic and larger picture of why do we care about all this. Sylvia Earle, her deepness is what she's called because she's done so much very deep ocean diving. Sylvia Earle's 15-minute talk at TED, which we've linked there, is I think a wonderful reminder of why we are doing all this, why we're interested in the coastal zones, and why it's worth our time to spend the next weeks basically discussing this. There are some nice discussion forums posted, reading about it, and interchanging ideas about the coasts and the oceans. So I hope you enjoy the class, and we will be seeing you on the internet shortly.